السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله أولا وآخرا، الحمد لله أبدا أبدا. إن الحمد لله وحده نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونعوذ به من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهديه الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ولن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، صدق وعده ونصر عبده وأعز جنده وهزم الأحزاب وحده لا شريك له، ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. ونشهد أن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله سبحانه، وإن خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وإن شر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى، وإنما توعدون لآت، وما أنتم بمعجزين. أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله سبحانه، فمن اتقى الله فقد نجا في الدنيا والآخرة. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وكونوا مع الصادقين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. My brothers and sisters, طبتم وطاب ممشاكم وتبوأتم من الجنة غرفا ومنازلا. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. In the name of Allah, the all merciful, the ever merciful, and the all praise and the blessings and salutations be upon the prophets and messengers from Adam عليه السلام to Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى: ما كان للمشركين أن يعمروا مساجد الله شاهدين على أنفسهم بالكفر أولئك حبطت أعمالهم وفي النار هم خالدون. إنما يعمر مساجد الله من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر وأقام الصلاة وآتى الزكاة ولم يخش إلا الله فعسى أولئك أن يكونوا من المهتدين. الله سبحانه وتعالى narrated this ayat in relationship to a very significant event early on when the Quraysh and the leaders of Mecca came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam arguing and telling him, we are ahlul balad al haram wa ahlul masjid al haram, we are the owners of this holy space which is means Mecca, and we are the owners or the one who preserve this holiest place of the holiest one on earth by providing food for those who are hungry, providing water for those who are thirsty, maintaining that place, building that place, and so on and so forth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded to them, saying that maintaining the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not for those who associate others with Him. ما كان للمشركين أن يعمروا مساجد الله شاهدين witnessing على أنفسهم against themselves by associating others with Allah or disbelieving in Him بالكفر. أولئك حبطت أعمالهم, all of their deeds are void. Why? Not because the deeds themselves are not good deeds, but because the intention of the deeds themselves are not transcending to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You might find someone that do a lot of good deeds in their lives, but these good deeds are made purposely for the people or for legacy or for leaving a name or a legacy behind, not for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the hadith Qudsi, أَنَا أَغْنَى الشُّرَكَاءِ عَنِ الشِّرْكِ, I'm not accepting associating or associates with me. Of those who should maintain the houses of Allah. And in the next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned and told us about the four main qualities of those who are adequate enough to maintain the house of Allah. What he said, إِنَّمَا يَعْمُرُ مَسَاجِدَ اللَّهِ. Those who maintain the houses of Allah are those مَنْ آمَنَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. Those who believe in Allah and on the day of judgment. We made a series a long time ago about our journey and the life after death. And some people might not find this relevant to the current status or our life right now, but it is deep-rooted relevant to this. Because how come you become a Muslim without maintaining your belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and in the day of judgment with the details that are narrated in the Quran and in the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? So the first quality of those who maintain truly the houses of Allah are the quality or the qualities of belief in Allah and belief in the Day of Judgment and the Unseen. The second quality for those who maintain the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is establishing prayers. وَأَقَامَ الصَّلَاةِ. And establishing prayers is not in the quantity of your prayers, it's the quality of each and every one of them. The quality that's mentioned in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said, يَأْتِ أَحَدُكُمْ يُصَلِّي وَيَتْرُكْ صَلَاتَهُ وَلَيْسَ لَهُ مِنْهَا إِلَّا عُشْرُهَا أَوْ سُدُسُهَا أَوْ خُمْسُهَا أَوْ رُبْعُهَا أَوْ ثُلُثُهَا أَوْ نِصْفُهَا. That each one of us come to the pray and pray exactly in the same rows, do exactly the same actions, leave the masjid exactly at the same time, and some of us might have 50% of their prayers are accepted or valid. And the other 50 is gone by their own distracted feelings and emotions and thinking during the prayers. Or some others might have only 1/10 of the prayer. So establishing or iqamatu salah, as our scholars taught us, establishing a salah is iqamatu salah wa ibaa'u kull ruknin wa kull harakatin haqqaha wa mustahaqqaha, by performing each and every pillar of salah so as it's supposed to be. That's the second quality. The third quality of those who maintain the masajid of Allah are the ones who give their own zakah. And zakah is not accurate at all to say charities, because zakah is beyond charities. Charities is something that we have the option and we are called generous if we give it out. But zakah, we're not even any close to be generous if we give it out, because that's your own duty. That's your own duty that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mandated in each one of us. خُذْ مِنْ أَمْوَالِهِمْ صَدَقَةً تُطَحِّرُهُمْ وَتُزَكِّيهِمْ بِهَا. Take from them, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, صَدَقَةً, zakah, تُطَحِّرُهُمْ, to purify them. When you go and eat, while you're hungry, you're not saying, I'm giving my body generous food. You're eating. Dessert might be something, a sign of luxury, but the basic food is the food بِحَسْبِ ابْنِ آدَمْ لُقَيْمَاتٍ يُقِمْنَ صُلْبُ. That's the basic thing. That's the third quality. The fourth quality is وَلَمْ يَخْشَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. The quality of those who maintain the masajid of Allah are the ones who do not fear anyone but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, are the ones that have only one factor for their decisions in their lives, big or small, is Allah and the rida of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I go and buy a house, my only one factor is Allah. When I go and feed my family, my factor is Allah. When I do my work, basic daily work, my only factor is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When I live my life, my only factor is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even my own intimate relationship with my own legitimate spouse is based on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is not a word of mine. This is a word of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَفِي بِضْعِ أَحَدُكُمْ صَدَقَةً. So the Sahaba got confused and said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ أَيَاتِ أَحَدُنَا شَهْوَتَهُ وَلَهُ بِهَا صَدَقَةً. قَالَ فَرْأَيْتَ إِنْ وَضَعَهَا فِي الْحَرَامِ أَكَانَتْ عَلَيْهِ وِزْرٌ. Don't you think that if that person meets or fits or fulfills their desire in a haram resources, will not be considered a haram or a sin? So if you fulfill it in a halal resources, that means that you're doing a sadaqah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my brothers and sisters, the topic of today is i'marul masajid, maintaining the houses of Allah. But what does that have to do with Ramadan in 2 weeks, or less than 2 weeks? Ramadan, my brothers and sisters, is the month of Quran, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. The month of barakah, as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, atakum shahrun mubarak. The month of ibadah, as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did. The month of perfection and mercy and forgiveness, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger said to us. So that's a month, as the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, atakum shahrun mubarak, shahr Ramadan. تفتح فيه أبواب الجنان وتغلق فيه أبواب النيران وتصفد فيه مردة الشياطين فيه ليلة خير من ألف شهر من حرمها أو حرم منها فقد حرم خيرا كثيرا أو فقد حرم. This is a month, a blessed month. So what that relationship between a masjid or a masajid or houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Ramadan, that's in 10 days or a little bit more than 10 days. The relationship, my brothers and sisters, maintaining the masjid is a big quality of maintaining your Ramadan. They are very connected and intertwined together. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the masajid, what He said? He said, فِي بِيُوتٍ أَذِنَ اللَّهُ أَن تُرْفَعَ وَيُذْكَرَ فِيهَا اسْمُهُ يُسَبِّحُ لَهُ فِيهَا بِالْغُدُوِّ وَالْآصَالِ رِجَالٌ لَا تُلْهِيهِمْ تِجَارَةٌ وَلَا بَيْعٌ عَنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَإِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ وَإِيتَاءِ الزَّكَاةِ يَخَافُونَ يَوْمًا تَتَقَلَّبُ فِيهِ الْقُلُوبُ وَالْأَبْصَارُ لِيَجْزِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوا وَيَزِيدَهُم مِّن فَضْلِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَرْزُقُ مَن يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talked about the masjid, connected the ibadah of the masjid. The ibadat of the masjid. But first and foremost, what is the meaning of the word imarat al-masjid, maintaining a house of Allah? Some team might call it maintaining the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by maintaining its walls, keeping it clean, maintaining the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by providing the resources that are needed for a house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to function in an appropriate and up to the bar ways and standards, which is true. But on the other side too, maintaining the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by maintaining the true meaning that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the famous hadith of Muttafaqun alayhi, when he said, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَلَائِكَةٌ سَيَّارَةٌ يَتَعَاقَبُونَ فِيكُمْ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ. Their job is to look for those who maintain the houses of Allah. Once they spot people worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and remembering Him in a house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or at a house of Allah, they say, halummu ila bughyatikum. They will come to them. وحفتهم الملائكة وغشيتهم الرحمة. So there are two ways of maintaining the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is the best way, or one of the best ways to receive Ramadan in a good way this year. What should I do then? What should I do is I maintain the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala physically. The house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if it is less cleaner and presentable than your house, that means that's not maintained. That you choose your own house to be meeting certain standards far more than the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Maintaining the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when I'm using the water in the house, the bathroom in the house, the carpet in the house, the light of the house, without considering that these resources that are used to facilitate my usage of this place that's dedicated to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah alone the house is dedicated for. The second I'm using them with less careless or with less careful use, that means I'm not maintaining the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he mentioned the seven people on the day of judgment that will be covered under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one of their, those types is رجل قلبه معلق بالمساجد. How come a Muslim, his heart or her heart is connected to the masjid, and the masjid is a littering place for them, is a place to put their trash, or the place to mess around without even considering this is might not be tahir, is a place that I put my paper towels or toilet papers in the floor and I don't care who cleans it afterwards. It's there. It's a public area. It's a gas station or a convenience store, whatever, that I'm using it, and then they're going to take care of it. No, this is not how we should treat the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, especially in this coming month. Because this coming month, your ibadah, half of it is connected to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Half of your ibadah, which is the salah, that each salah equal 10 times, is connected to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Half of the taraweeh is connected to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala get more busy. So the physical maintenance of the house of Allah is maintaining the house of Allah look, maintaining the house of Allah smell in a perfect possible way, presentable way, because this is my own duty towards the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My house, I'm using it for my family. The Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he taught us, and when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us in the Quran, the first thing that he told Sayyidina Ibrahim, the Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, may Allah be pleased with him, the first thing he told him after building the Kaaba, after building the actual walls, he told him, وَطَحِّرْ بَيْتِي, cleanse my house. للطائفين, those who come and do the tawaf, والقائمين, and those who pray, والركع السجود, and those who prostrate and do ركوع in front of me, clean my house. وطهر بيتي للطائفين والقائمين والركع السجود, وأذن في الناس بالحج, and the other thing, call the people to come to pray. So my brothers and sisters, that's the true maintenance of the house. The other maintenance of the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the spiritual maintenance, is the abstract, is iqamatu salah, performing the prayers. It is shame on us, or on a few of us, I would say few, that 35 prayers in the week, we pray one or two or three in the house of Allah, while we're capable to pray in the house of Allah more than this. 35 prayers, it's not even 10%. 10% of our ibadah is not done in the appropriate place that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dedicated for that reason. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ فَلَا تَدْعُوا مَعَ اللَّهِ أَحَدًا. The masajid, the houses, are made for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and this is why they are made for Allah. And in the other ayah, في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه يسبح له فيها بالغدو والأصال. So maintaining the house of Allah by our presence in the house of Allah, by our presence in this house or other houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that are established in this earth, by our calm and peaceful presence in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not looking for argument and ولا رفث ولا جدال ولا فسوق. There's no arguments, there's no fighting, there's nothing but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Taking off my shoes, taking off any attachment to anything, and declaring ألا ما دون الله باطل. Void, everything is void. It's Allah only. It's Allah only subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's so many ways that you can welcome and receive this Ramadan. And one of the biggest ways of them is maintaining the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. له الملك وله الحمد. وهو على كل شيء قدير. وأشهد أن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله، وعلى آله وأصحابه الغر الميامين، ومن اتبعه واهتدى بهديه واستنى بسنته إلى يوم الدين، اللهم آمين. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the four qualities, belief in Allah and in the Day of Judgment, performing and establishing the prayers, paying the zakah, fearing no one but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He ended the ayah by saying, فَعَسَى أُولَٰئِكَ أَنْ يَكُونُوا مِنَ الْمُهْتَدِينَ. Indeed, the word asa in Arabic means literally maybe. But in the Quran, فَعَسَى أَنْ يَبْعَثَكَ رَبُّكَ مَقَامًا مَحْمُودًا doesn't mean maybe. It means indeed, those are the guided ones, or among the guided ones. So, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we wrap up with this hadith, said something beautiful about continuing to maintain the house by visiting the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by connecting our hearts to the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, by physically keeping the houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala up to bar and clean. He said, أَلَا أَدُلُّكُمْ عَلَى مَا يَمْحُ اللَّهُ بِهِ الْخَطَايَا وَيَرْفَعُ بِهِ الدَّرَجَاتِ. Do you want me to tell you about what erases the sins and elevate the person in positions and rewards before Allah? قَالُوا بَلَى. He gives three actions. One of them is إِسْبَاغُ الْوُضُوءِ عَلَى الْمَكَارِهِ. Performing your wudu, even though it's difficult for you to perform. And this is a very, like, a profound statement from the Prophet ﷺ. Back in the time, to get a bucket of water is a work, is an effort. Right now we just do this, or we even do that, and then automatically the water comes to our body. But at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, in a cold night, to make wudu for fajr is a jihad. It's something that needs a lot of work. It's not something that get in your car, make sure that it's hot enough, or warm enough so you can jump in the masjid. Get in the masjid, it's warm enough, nice carpet, nice water, cool and it's not cold and hot, and it's everything is perfect, and then you make wudu and say, Alhamdulillah, I'm doing a lot for Allah. Wal-a'yadu billah. No. Back in the time when you make your wudu, that means you need to work hard to get a very freezing water, especially in a cold night. Make wudu with it. Go out and walk in the middle of darkness because there's no light, and pray in the masjid that the floor is hasa, is a small sand and stones. إسباغ الوضوء, when you perform and perfect your wudu, even though it's difficult, is one way to erase your sins and to elevate you in positions of Allah. إسباغ الوضوء على المكاره. Number two, وكثرة الخطى إلى المساجد. Make your feet frequently attending the services in the masjid and the salawat in the masjid. Make the masjid in your Google Maps is a frequent visited place. Is a regular visited place. Is not a place that I look up for once a week to go and pray the Jum'ah. That's number two. Number three, وَإِنْتِظَارُ الصَّلَاةِ إِلَى الصَّلَاةِ. When you perform your prayers, you have nothing to do. Wait for the next prayer. These three actions erases the sins, elevate the person in rewards before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is one of the best ways, my brothers and sisters, to welcome this Ramadan, by dealing with the masajid differently. By maintaining the masjid physically and spiritually in a different way. But not using this place or other places as a public place that couldn't care less about maintaining it. I see like trash on the floor and I just don't care. I make my wudu, pray and leave. Someone else did this trash and it's their fault. But also, طهر بيتي للطائفين والعاكفين والركع السجود. فاللهم بلغنا رمضان على أحسن حال. اللهم عنا فيه على صيامه وقيامه وقراءة القرآن يا رب العالمين. اللهم لا تدعنا نخرج من رمضان إلا وقد غفرت لنا. اللهم أكرم نزلنا ووسع مدخلنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وصلى الله وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم. وأقم الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر.